You got any more in there?
Just this one. You better watch out. It's dangerous.
This little mutt doesn't look dangerous to me.
Maybe so, but he bit the kennel master. And that's never happened before.
So you bit the kennel master, did you? Huh. And you'll probably get rabies.
Dog catcher, Bertie.
I'm not a dog catcher. I'm a canine technician.
When the kennel master finds out about this, you'll be scraping cages with your toothbrush.
I don't think he needs to know. He hates that little dog. Besides, I know how to get it back.
Oh.
You ain't bright enough to have any secrets.
This is a secret, Jake.
What is
it? I never could hit those airplanes. I used to miss those airplanes all the time.
Guess I better go away. Maybe you ain't safe to be with. How'd you ever get to be a machine gun?
Hi, what's up?
Private guy.
I want a transfer.
Did I miss anything?
It's too late. You're stuck with me.
You see that crisp girl?
I'm going to get that car.
I'm going to aim.
She's been giving Jason a surprise inspection.
The stuff was too hard.
I told you, she's got a crush on you big time. Quiet, she'll hear you.
Half the money to whoever catches them. Bernie wants this one bad.
Come on.
Mom.
Hi, Dad.
Hey, Fenton.
Weren't you out just a little bit late last night, young man?
Gee, I, Mom, didn't you hear?
Hear what?
Well, you remember my friend, Ralph, don't you?
No, I don't think so.
Well, anyway, he got in an accident, and, his nose was ripped right off and stuff, and the doctor said he can't breathe without it. They're giving him oxygen shots to keep him alive, but, he's probably gonna die. Today. Anyway, he, kind of has this dog, and kind of asked me to take care of it.
Don't you think I should talk to Ralph's parents first?
Oh, no, you can't do that. They were so sad, they went to Tahiti to see witch doctors.
Tahiti?
The point of this conversation seems to be that you want another dog. Am I correct?
Jason, we're not ready to have another dog yet. An animal is a big responsibility. You remember what happened to Norton?
But I am more responsible now. I'm class president.
Well, you've shown your classmates you can do that job. You haven't shown your father and me that you can take care of a dog.
He's a fun tea bear.
Oh, I'm sure he's around here somewhere. We'll look for him after breakfast.
Julie, tea bear had a little bit of an accident. He was dirty, so I decided I'd give him a bath. Well, he kind of fell apart in the spin cycle. He went down the drain and up to heaven.
No. No, you hurt T-Bear.
It's okay, though. Yes, son. Look, Julie, he's even got two eyes, see?
It's not T-Bear. I want T-Bear.
Anyway, about Ralph's dog, can we
We'll talk about Ralph's dog later, Jason.
Julie, you've been in there all morning. Mom says you gotta come out for lunch.
No.
Julie, Mom made your favorite, chocolate sundaes and jelly beans.
No.
Julie, I got something that I can show you, but you've gotta promise not to tell Mom and Dad.
What is it?
Something really, really special. Much better.
What is it?
It's in here somewhere. Let me get the light. Douse the light! That light could show the Water Street gang our exact position.
Hi, Jason. Clint said I could join your club.
He did?
He did.
Come here, let me talk to you. She likes you, man. Besides, we could have fun initiating her. No, wait a minute. Do you know what kind of club this is?
No, what kind is it?
Well, you know, it's a guys' club. It's baseball in the summer, football in the fall, basketball in the winter, and training all spring.
No problem.
We're not bending any rules on account of you being a girl.
I wouldn't expect you to raise your standards for one member.
Jason, where's the surprise? Oh, Jason. I love him. What's his name?
Okay, you guys. I figure if we all pitch in, we can buy food for the dog and let him live here.
Yeah, you know, our club needs a mascot. Your mom is gonna blow chow.
She doesn't have to know. This dog's gonna be our secret, and we're gonna be responsible for him.
What's his name? I can get him a collar.
And my dad has some old dog tags.
Yeah, my mom cooks some stuff that tastes like dog food.
But what's his name?
Patton.
Brandy, Scooter.
No, wait a minute. We got to decide on a name that everybody likes.
Button.
Button? Don't make me sick. The dog's name is Patton. Or Sherman. I like Sherman.
No, I think he should be called Scooter. Or Harley. Call him Cheesecake.
Cheesecake?
I like cheesecake. Wendell, why can't you forget about food for once?
So anyway, we're all going to pitch in and keep the dog, right?
Yeah. Okay, now that you've let the dog in the club, what about me?
Before you can become an official member of this club, you have to pass the initiation.
Inside that house lives the hermit.
He's the most frightful, hideous, sick-looking demon that has ever lived.
And they say he killed a king.
And that's not all. The house?
No one has ever seen the hermit. You've got to take a picture of him.
I can't do that. It's, very rude.
I knew she was a chicken.
Me too.
Knock on the door, take his picture, and you'll be a member.
Well, it's been nice knowing you.
Boy, something scaring you?
It's like he sent us something.
Those look pretty good. Yeah, yeah.
Hold it. We want $15 for these.
15? No, no. The kennel master says 10, and that's it.
Let him go.
No, wait. I'll give you 12. Save me the trouble of having to catch them.
Throw them in the back. We'll meet you here tomorrow. But you tell the kennel master, from now on, the dogs are $15.
All right, well, I'll tell him, but I don't think he's going to be very happy.
Edward, Uncle Bernie's got you. Uncle Bernie's here. Look what I found. A nosy little spy.
What were you doing over there?
I bet he saw Evan.
No, no.
He's lying.
That's what his face
is. No, I didn't see anything. I won't tell anybody about those dogs.
I think you better make sure.
No! No!
See? No head.
No wonder nobody knows what he looks like.
So does anyone know where Wendell is?
Maybe the hermit caught him.
No, he probably wimped out and went home to Mama.
Never mind, let's get on with the initiation. What you are about to see is a secret that you must carry to your grave. Two new members will be joining our club tonight.
Hey, wait a minute. We've got to give this dog a name.
I like Commando.
Turbo Pup. Spy.
Shut up.
You guys.
Must be a solemn occasion.
I'll raise your right hand for the sacred oath. Friends always will stick together.
In trouble or in fun.
Christy?
Oh. Our loyalty will last forever. Because, baby, we're born right.
All
welcome
right.
To the team.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, Christy. I got to get the dog home.
Oh, that's very funny.
Why don't you sit down for a minute and catch your breath?
No, I got to get the dog home and feed him.
I think he wants to stay a while.
Traitor.
Besides, he doesn't look like he needs much food. You know, Jason, you could get dizzy if you look at the stars while you're standing.
You see that star? The bright one? That's the dog star.
How did it get that name?
Well, it's really serious.
Why? What happened?
No, the star. It's called Sirius.
Seriously?
Forget it. I'm going home.
Wait! Jason, you know what we have in common with that star?
What?
We could be Sirius, too.
That's okay. I gotta go. I gotta feed the dishes and wash the dog.
Jason?
Yes, Mom?
There's something we want to talk to you about.
Your mother and I had to go down to the basement today.
I'll never guess what we found.
Bet I could.
We found Norton's old dog dishes and his basket. So I said to your mother, can you think of any reason why we should keep this old stuff?
So I said, well, Norton ran away a long time ago. Maybe it's time we got another dog.
So we decided that you can have Ralph's dog.
You're my dog now. Can't wait till tomorrow and you get to meet my mom and dad. I promise to take real good care of you. And I won't let anybody hurt you, no matter what. Good night, boy. Oh, no. He must have gotten out that window.
Jason, didn't you lock it?
Well, I might have if you hadn't run me all over the place last night.
Don't blame me.
I paid $1.50 for this chew toy. Maybe I should have checked the window.
No, I wouldn't worry. He's probably out cruising the neighborhood.
Maybe he got run over.
I mean, excuse me, officers. We have a missing canine terrier, Mutt Mix. Said animal is wearing a silver reflective collar and dog tags. Have you seen this dog, or do you have any idea of its current whereabouts?
What's his name?
His name?
Yeah. Well, you better find him before dark, because we're on curfew duty every night this week, and I don't get any calls about you and your pal's monkey business. You read me?
Yes, sir.
See you later, trooper.
Don't worry, Julie. We'll find him. He's with T-Bear. I know.
Wait a minute. This is where that creepy old hermit lives.
Maybe he's seen our doggy.
I don't think we should bug him.
I'm not scared.
Get out of here, I'll crush you! I'll get you next time.
Wendell, is that you?
Hi, guys. What's up?
Wendell, where have you been?
I don't know. I had some stuff I had to do.
Well, aren't you going to come outside and talk to us?
My mother wants me to clean my room.
Wendell, please, our dog is missing.
Come on, man, we need your help.
Oh, Wendell.
Wendell, what happened?
It was the Water Street gang. I caught him stealing some dogs and selling to a man from the kennel. I was going to tell you guys, but he beat me up.
Wendell, did they have our dog?
No, I would have told you right away. They got some kind of deal going on.
Oh, man, they're taking dogs. Come on.
Wendell, come on.
I'm telling you, dogs are getting harder to find. I'm taking a big risk doing them. You gotta give us more money for the ones we deliver.
Seems to me there's plenty more dogs in this town, and I'm already paying you top dollar. Now get out of here. I got business to attend to. Not that way. Out the back.
Hey, what do you kids want?
We'd like to take a look at your dog.
What for?
Because
we're working on a school project about how a kennel operates.
School project? But isn't it summer?
Haven't you ever heard of summer school?
Oh, yeah.
So, did you get in this line of work just so you could wear that snappy uniform?
He's here! Jason, he's here!
Hey, put him on my interview!
Him, it's our doggy!
It is him.
Jason, I thought you said he had a collar.
Please, mister, let our doggy out.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, I can't do that. That's not your dog.
What do you mean it's not our dog? Just because you guys took his collar off?
Hey, look, I'm just a canine technician around here. I think you guys better talk to the kennel master.
Kennel master?
Come in.
Excuse me, sir. We're here about our dog. You have him here by mistake.
This is a kennel. Dogs don't end up here by mistake.
But it is our dog.
Do you have any proof of ownership?
Well, he had a collar, but somebody took it off.
Well, already. Let's have a look at this dog.
All right, here we are.
This is him. He's our dog.
What, this one?
Yeah.
This one? No, this isn't your dog. Why isn't this case tagged? Let me tell you people something. This is a dangerous animal. The law requires that it be kept in isolation for 1 week before it's destroyed.
Destroyed?
That's right, destroyed. When we examined the creature, it bit my assistant. Isn't that right, Bernie?
I guess that's the one.
See that? He's confused. That's the first sign of rabies. That dog is rabid, and you children have been exposed. Bernie, get the shots.
Shots?
No.
Wait a minute. Bernie, would you like a drink of water?
Huh? Sure, why not?
Rabies is also known as hydrophobia, or fear of water. Bernie doesn't seem to be afraid of water.
It's all right. Then explain this, young lady.
Hey! Hey, Bernie, where are you going?
See that? And the dog reacts the same way.
Quit that!
Get out of here. Kids better get out of here or I'm going to have to call your parents.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Running this kennel for 13 years, and no dog's ever bit me before. You're never getting out of here again.
Don't worry, son. We'll have your dog out of here in no time.
The guy, Dad.
Well, you've come back, young man. Is this your father?
My son tells me we have a little problem here.
I'm glad you came out. I'd like to get this straightened out as much as you would. Get in there. Get in
here. He says you have his dog here and won't give it back.
Well, sir, it's really just a misunderstanding. My kennel has been a pillar of service in this community for 13 years. I'm sure
That's all very fine, but why can't he have his dog?
Well, first of all, it's not his dog. It was brought in here by a young couple a few weeks ago. The dog did escape, but he was returned by the police a couple of days later. Maybe your son ran across him while he was out loose.
That's not true.
This young couple, I think they'd be willing to sell the dog. Perhaps I could contact them.
I think I better tell you the whole story here. You see, we've had to place the dog in isolation.
Isolation?
Yeah, I don't want to alarm you, but we suspect the dog might have contracted rabies. You're very fortunate your son wasn't bitten. He could have become very sick.
Can't you see he's lying? There's nothing wrong with my dog.
I understand how the young man feels. Maybe we could find him another dog. Hey, Bernie! Bernie, bring out the Smith dog. Oh, this beautiful animal was abandoned here nearly a year ago. I think you'd give him a wonderful home.
I don't want another dog. I want my dog.
Here he is. Beautiful. Yeah.
What's going to happen to the other dog?
When are you going to let him out of isolation?
That dog will be destroyed on Monday. It'd be cruel to keep him alive any longer.
Jason, could your dad do anything?
No. Kennel's got their story wrapped up airtight.
Maybe we'll have to try to find another mascot.
We can't stand by and let them execute our dog. Maybe we don't have to stand by.
What do you mean, Jason?
We're gonna bust him out ourselves.
What?
We took a sacred oath. Now one of our team is in trouble. It's our duty to bust him out.
We have 6 days to get ready for this mission. We can't afford to waste a single minute. While some of us are training, others of us will be gathering supplies or information about the target. Okay?
Okay.
This is it, the Puppy Town Kennel. We're gonna have to go in Saturday night when nobody is there. Our first obstacle will be getting past this area. Water Street, enemy territory.
No, no way! You're not taking me in there! When those guys see me, they're gonna shoot me home in a box!
Calm down, buddy. No. Take it easy. You're not the school.
Look, Wendell, we're all scared of the Water Streeters, but it's the only way we can save our dog. All right, now remember, once we get out of the old Wheatstone Tunnel, we'll be fair game until we get to the kennel.
Yeah, my dad's on curfew duty. If we get caught, mission's over. Okay, I've assigned each of you duties to help get us ready. Clint and Christy will be in charge of physical training. And Clarence, you're going to use your helicopter to get reconnaissance photographs of the target. Christy will build us a model of the kennel to help us plan our attack. And Wendell...
Rations.
Okay, Wendell will be in charge of rations. All right, you guys. We've only got one shot, and our dog's life depends on it. We can't and won't mess up.
Yeah!
All right. Jason, this is not regulation training.
Okay, boys, let's go.
Bunch of old ladies in my life.
You people stink!
The fence is 8 feet high and topped with barbed wire. I'm gonna have to hide a ladder in the bushes that's tall enough to get us over. That's the easy part.
That's right, guys. The building is solid concrete block. Surveillance cameras. Here and here. Whoever built this sucker sure didn't want anybody getting in.
Well, Clarence, how do we get past the cameras? Think I know somebody who can do the job.
I'm telling you, Jason, this guy's all wrong for our mission. He flunked Jim. Whoa! What a weenie.
That's our man.
Excuse us, sir.
What are you doing here? This is private property.
Remember me from the science fair? You built that particle accelerator?
Oh, yes, yes. And you had the dead ant farm. Very enlightening.
Yeah. Well, anyway, we're organizing a secret mission. And we need a man of your talents on our team.
Sorry, not interested.
Why not?
I have far more important things to do than get involved in a bunch of kids' games.
Now listen, you little four-eyed pencil neck. This isn't a kids' game. It's the real thing.
Where did you dredge up this Neanderthal?
Hey, bud, watch or else I'm going to give you a fat lip.
Good. It'll match your head.
Let's go.
Come on.
Wait, Melvin. Our dog's life is at stake.
The dog? Well, why didn't you say so? You just stay here a second. I'll get my briefcase. I'll be right with you.
First, we'll blind this surveillance camera with Melvin's smoke bomb. Then someone will scale the roof, drop into this courtyard, and enter through one of the cages.
Well, that's all very well and good, but it's not that simple. What about alarms? Or electric eyes? We've got to know what's inside that kennel. We need the blueprint. Yeah, luckily I've got an uncle that works at the city archives. But I have to warn you guys, he's a real nerd. Yeah. These blueprints should tell us exactly what we need to know.
Okay.
Ah! Oh! Simply put the microfiche in here and search away.
Getting pretty worried about us pulling this off. I know everybody's trying, but maybe it's not enough.
We'll pull it off. You'll see.
Hey, that's the kennel!
Hey, guys, check this out. Come here.
Accident closes down amusement park. Is that the Hermit?
Well, Jason, nobody else has an amusement park around here.
It says here that that boy was killed in an accident. That poor man must have felt just terrible.
Good. What sort of uniform is that?
United States Army Lieutenant. And look, it even says right here that he won the Medal of Valor.
For Harvard.
Yet? Oh. It's you. Did you come by to take my picture? Huh?
No, sir.
Why, aren't you scared of the Hermit?
You're not a hermit. You're a war hero. You led a raid.
That's right. I did. Back in 45.
Yeah. Do you think you could do it again?
What?
A raid. You wouldn't have to lead it or anything. Just show us how to do it.
Us? Who's us?
Oh. Hey, Chris, he's got his head on now.
Oh, I see.
Excuse me, sir. Is this house really haunted?
Is it haunted? You mean the dishes go rattling around and flying all over the rooms from one side of the wall to the other? Furniture that slip and slide all over the place? Is that what you mean? Do the walls breathe in and out? Is that what you mean? Huh? Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
No. No, it doesn't. But I've got some cold milk in there and some cookies that can disappear before your eyes just like that. Come on.
I'll help you, sir.
All right, everybody into the living.
of valor.
Hey! Hey, what are you fellas doing?
You really were a war hermit. A war hero.
I was just doing my duty. Well, now that we're all here, what's on all of your minds?
Well, suppose some kids had a real important secret mission. They'll need a few days to get ready. And let's say they knew about this guy who had pulled off a mission just like it, and they asked him for his help. If you were that guy, do you think you would help him?
Well, I might. If I knew it was safe. What kind of a mission did you have in mind?
It's a secret mission, a rescue.
A very daring rescue.
Well, if it's a mission that's this important to you all and everything, couldn't you ask your families or your folks to help you with?
No way. We've got to sneak in, grab what we're after, and sneak out like spies.
Spies? Little spies.
Well, yes, sir. See, we made a promise to a friend, and the time's come to keep that promise.
You know, a promise is one of the most powerful things in the world. And if it's time for you to keep that promise, then it's time. I haven't had anything to do since I lost Mildred. But if you can all use me in any way, then I can help you. I'll do it.
Yeah. All right, come on in. This can help you with your training on your mission. This has been closed for many years, ever since that Rydell boy got killed on the roller coaster. Somebody had dared him to stand up, and I've had to live with that tragedy for many, many years. There we go. There she is. Come on in. Come on in.
Rides are the best in the universe. I helped build most of them.
Over there. That's what would start our training. All right, children, you wait there. I'll be back in just a second.
Now, what do you suppose that old fox was up to?
Well, what sort of training is this?
It's the kind of training that, That's right, it'll sharpen your reflexes. Come on, we'll try some other things.
All right, son, let it swing it nice and easy, that's it. Now let it go whenever you're ready. That's it. Whoop! Now you hook it. Now, keep it good and taut.
All right, son. Now aim it right down that barrel. Squeeze that trigger very slowly and soft. Perfect! That was perfect, my boy. Load her up again. Don't point it at me. Right there. That's it.
Come on. Go for it. Watch this.
All right, everybody. Remember, I'll be timing you. Ready? Go!
Get here.
Oh, Grace. Well, carefully, there's a dog in here somewhere.
Oh, no.
All right, miss, spread out.
Come on, guys. Is this really such a good idea?
It's really dark in here.
Here we go. This one. Yeah.
Come on, go.
Come on. Wendell.
Hey.
Come on, I see it. Let's go!
Melvin will be the cowboy. Clarence will be the cow. Clarence will be the monkey.
I
don't
want to be a monkey.
Chris will be the robot, and I'll be the soldier.
I want to be a soldier.
I don't
want to
be a cow.
Christy, will you be the cow?
Fine. Good, let's get on with it.
All right, let's review the plan. First, we're going to blind this surveillance camera with Melvin's smoke bomb.
Now remember, you're only going to have about a minute before the smoke starts.
Clint will use the ladder to get over this fence.
Oh?
Once he is inside, he'll have to activate this electric gate by jumping on the air hose. From here, he'll proceed to the wall and secure the grappling hook as he and Clarence scale the wall. While Clint deals with the cameras here,
one,
and here,
two,
Clarence has got to drop down into here and gain access to the kennel area from this outside run.
Now, this wiring diagram represents an electric cage locking system. This button here must be activated before any of the cages can be opened.
Don't worry. I'm prepared for that.
Well, what if the Water Street Gang catches us?
We can't let the Water Street Gang catch us, or we'll be starting school from our hospital then. I really think we're going to be safe once we reach the junkyard.
Safe? What about Max? Max?
We're gonna avoid Max by going around the junkyard and then pow, puppy town.
10 bucks ain't enough. I got overhead.
Sell your dog someplace else.
Nobody else wants dog.
Precisely.
What's wrong with you?
That dog belongs to those punks. Looks too sick to sell. What you gonna do with it?
See the way he looks at me? See how frightened he is? He thinks I'm evil. Evil. People throw their animals in the streets, allowing them to roam freely, contracting diseases, breeding indiscriminately. I figured out what to do with their unwanted dogs. Do you think that's evil?
Should be in here someplace. You say?
Well, Lieutenant, I kind of got a couple of...
Wait, look, you don't have to call me. Just call me Jimmy.
Yes, sir. Kind of got a couple of problems.
Christine, what else?
Well, it's something... How'd you know about Christy?
Well, Christy looked at me with those doe eyes of hers. That would be one of my problems.
Hey, I swear, it's not me. It's been her all
What's
along.
What's the matter? Don't you like her?
Okay.
Now, I have a funny feeling that in years to come, you're going to feel much different about that.
Suppose a guy did like a girl.
Yeah?
How would he go about kissing her anyway?
Kissing? Well, it's been a long time. First of all, you'd have to get real close. You know, you just kind of... Oh, I look stupid. it out. What else is bothering you?
Something that happened a long time ago.
Oh?
Guess it wasn't really my fault. Lately, it's just coming around to haunt me.
Yeah, it's a funny thing about life. You try and do a lot of good things, help people, make people happy, and then when something bad happens, it takes all that good that you try and do and just runs it down the drain. But you know what? I've learned one thing over the years. You have to face up to it. Or else you'll end up an old, scary hermit like me. Now this raid you've been talking about. None of you are going to get hurt by doing this thing, are you?
No, sir.
I want you to take along my lucky dog tags from World War II.
I couldn't take your dog tags. If they're yours, they're from the war.
I want you to take them just on the raid. And after you're done, you can give them back to me.
Downstairs, so be a good girl while I'm gone.
Here to see you. She loves to see people in uniform.
Sir, we're ready.
Before you move out on your mission, I've written something I want you all to listen to. In all my years in the Army, it was my pleasure to see some of the finest troops in the world go into action. But I have to say that I have never seen a bunch quite like this. Especially a group that won't tell me what their mission is. Aside from that, I know that you're going to do yourselves proud. You're going to make me proud of you. And I'll be monitoring your walkie-talkies on my old shortwave set in the house. That's it. Tit, put! Move out!
Wendell.
Nice outfit.
This is it.
Wow!
Norton?
Norton? Who's Norton?
Norton was our family dog. I had to watch him one day back when I was about 8. Went inside for a second. And he just ran out into the street. Got hit by a car. Guy didn't even stop. Anyway, Norton was dead. I got a box and I brought him here and buried him. Told everybody he ran away.
It's okay, Jason.
So tonight, we're gonna save a dog. I wanted to come here so Norton would know that. All right, you guys, let's go get our dog.
Let's go.
All right, you guys. As soon as we enter this tunnel, we're going to be in Water Street territory. The success of this mission now lies on every move we make. If anybody wants to turn back, I won't hold it against them.
Where do you think you're going?
I was just getting a running start.
All right, this way.
A repair crew? What are they doing here?
That was the way we were supposed to go. No problem.
Melvin.
I'm telling you, my highly trained instincts say we gotta go down that alley.
And you're gonna give us away.
I'll tell you who's gonna give us away. It's this four-eyed science wiener. He's gonna lead us right in the Water Street gang.
Come on.
I don't think it's too safe here, Clint.
No.
I told you.
Oh.
do you want from us? We're on a peaceful mission.
Shut up! You honked that process one time too many.
Where'd you get the costume, you slimy little blubber ball?
Well, my mom made it last Halloween.
I know how to make these guys tell us what we want to know.
All right, come on.
Julie.
Get up here.
Where'd she come from?
Come on. I found a kid lost by the tunnel.
You leave my sister alone.
Yeah.
Julie, what?
I just wanted to help save our doggy.
Your dog? Your dog prayed dead by now.
Don't listen to him, Julie. He's lying.
Yeah. What do you know?
You bunch of wimps.
Don't you think we can talk this out like intelligent human beings?
Guys, come on.
Hustle up, you guys. Move it, move it.
Look, it's a junkyard.
Come on, no, come on, come on, come on. It's a good thing we got away from those guys. I was right about some
angles. Oh, no.
Guard up, guys. I know Max is here somewhere.
Oh!
What was that, Max?
You guys stay here while we scout it out. Keep quiet.
What was that noise? Don't be scared, Julie.
Come on, 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 come on,
Get away, dog. Get off of me. Yeah!
Good job! All right, Clarence just went over.
Joe, he's okay.
Look, there he is!
Let's go, come on!
Wait a minute, Kennel Master's in there.
Well,
that's his problem.
All right, just wait a minute. We're gonna have to be extra quiet. You stay here and stand guard.
Oh, come on. Come on. Guard! Guard! Why do I have to stand guard?
Isolation room.
Okay, everybody, here we go.
Hold it. There's an alarm beam in front of that door. Back away, slowly. Step over the site carefully. Any breach of the beam will notify the Kennel Master of our presence.
Gotcha.
Here, come on. Come on, hand her over.
Here we go, I got you. Okay, everybody, let's move it. Not here.
You don't seem safe. Maybe the Water Street gang was right. Maybe they did kill him.
Please don't let him be dead, Jason.
Jason, I think we're too late.
How's the diet going, Bernie?
Pretty good.
What about all these other dogs? Please, let's let them out.
They should run and play and stuff. Just one more time.
You can't.
Why?
Most of these dogs belong to people. They're cared for here. People come to a kennel when they want to buy a dog. Time to go home.
Come on. Come on, guys. We gotta get out of here.
Come on.
Why? Look, Jason! Oh, Jason, look.
Sorry, boy. Tried. God needed a dog. He wanted to find the best one that there was. he's alive.
What?
Are you sure?
He's barely breathing, but he's alive.
All right.
He's back. I knew he would.
We gotta get him some help right away.
Oh, guys, it might not be the right time, but that Bernie guy and his big old ugly truck driver just drove up.
Wendell, you breached the beam.
Beam?
Uh-oh.
Come on, let's go.
Come on.
Oh, come on, come on, come on.
Hello, you've reached the Puppy Love Kennels, where animal care is a science. We're not in right now, so leave your message at the tone.
Just a message, come on.
Duke from Underwood Scientific. Listen, the driver should be getting there any minute. We're expanding our experiment, so bump that order up from 15 to 30 dogs.
Experiments?
I can't believe it.
You wait for us at the gate.
Oh,
come on.
Come on, you guys, wait. Come on. Oh, gee, come on.
Oh, I can.
Let them all out. Right now.
I'm going to round up the rest of your troublemaking friends.
Wait here, I gotta find her. Julie! 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 Julie, where are you? Julie! Julie! Julie!
A second. Let me open that for you.
You let my sister out now.
I'm afraid there's some complications with that request. You see, you kids are going to jail soon.
No, you're the one that's going to jail. Once we tell everybody what you're doing.
What do you think I'm doing?
You're selling people's dogs for experiments.
There's no laws against selling unwanted animals for research.
People's dogs, we know.
You have no proof. It's your word against mine. And you know how that one works.
Jason, get the key! Jason, hurry! Come on!
I can't find the right one. I'm trying. Here, give me the dog. Run, Julie, go!
Too late, man.
He was a brave little dude.
let's go.
Bye, guys!
Well, come on, let's get out while we stop.
Come on, let's go!
Let's go! Come on! Jimmy, you gotta help our dog. He's real sick.
Mildred?
Mildred?
God, that's my dog, Mildred. Gone for months. What's the matter with it?
Her? We rescued him from the kennel. They were gonna kill her.
Kill her? Here, give her to me. Let me take her. Wait a minute.
She's the dog all along.
Poor Wendell. He was so brave.
Don't worry, Julie. Everything will be okay.
Oh, sure it will. We just broke into the kennel, released a few hundred dogs, lost one of our team, too. Everything's going to be just fine.
Yeah, but they were stealing people's dogs.
Yes, but we have no proof.
Proof or no proof? We're in some deep trouble.
Are they going to put us in jail?
Maybe for a while, I don't know. Probably let us out for school, though.
We'll know pretty soon. Police are here. It's Clint's dad. Wendell and those kennel guys are with him.
There in the middle of the room. I want your hands out in front where I can see them.
Dad, can I explain?
You have the right to remain silent. I heard about what you kids were up to tonight. Wendell told me everything. I don't know whether to take you over my knee or shake your hand. We've been trying to figure out for months what's been happening to all the dogs in this community.
Everything's gonna be all right, guys. I played him this tape from the answering machine, and Big Al's on it. The scientific place, too. Clint's dad is gonna take Bernie and Kennel Master to jail.
All right!
And when we catch up with those Water Streeters, they're gonna spend a lot of time in juvenile hall.
Does this mean that we're not in trouble, Dad?
No. It means you're not in as much trouble. Every one of you kids you're going to go home and tell your parents exactly what you did. But if they're like me, I think they'll understand. But next time, before you try anything even close to this, check with me first. I like dogs, too. You better be in bed by the time I get home. And wash your face.
Hey, fellas, she's all right. She's in there resting now.
Sir, we want to thank you for everything you've...
Oh, wait a minute. You got it all wrong. It's me that should be thanking you for all the trouble you went through to bring Mildred back here. If there's any more trouble, well, you can always count on your commander being there.
Thanks, sir. Well, we've got to be getting home now.
Home? Wait a minute. Can you help me with these puppies? Sure, come on in. Here, take your time. Hey,
love you. They're adorable.
Hey, look at this, huh?
Cute.
I'm going to name this one Norton.
Norton, why?
He kind of looks like him. I'm going to name this one Patton.
Patton.
Yeah. His name is Nikita.
Are you?
That was Einstein.
Seriously, we really want to thank you.
Worked, didn't it? Huh?